Good afternoon and thank you very much. Chairman of the Committee of Ambassadors, Her Excellency Mrs. Amo Asisa Barut, Secretary General of the ACP, Dean of the ACP Ambassadors, Excellencies, colleagues. First of all, on behalf of my President, His Excellency Desiree Delano Boutersen, the government and the multicultural Surinamese people, I bring you fresh warm and greetings from Suriname, the most forested country on earth. Colleagues, it is my distinct honor to address this committee for the first time as Ambassador of the Republic of Suriname. Shortly after our independence on November 25, 1975, Suriname joined the ACP. As for my country, I want to highlight that the ACP group of 79 states is unique, and my government is of the opinion that the ACP should continue as an entity and work on its relevance, effectiveness, and bargaining power, as this is a superb showcase of true multilateralism and strength. As we are now heavily focused on the negotiations with the European Union, the strength of our own organization, the ACP, and the mechanisms that we are able to create therein are of very great importance. The European Union is our largest development partner, and my government will take every opportunity to assure that after the end of the Cotonou Partnership Agreement, we can establish a new modern agreement based on the principles of mutual respect and mutual interest. But while our partnership with the European Union is important, and while we support the global partnership in realizing the Sustainable Development Goals and the protection of the environment, we must also make sure that we continue to strengthen our own intra-regional institutions to increase South-South cooperation and intra-regional trade. As was previously mentioned by my Minister of Foreign Affairs, the government of Suriname is of the opinion that we must expand the focus of the relationship with the European Union to contain not only development aid, but also, importantly, transfer of technology and cooperation on global matters such as education, health, mitigation of climate change, among others. Chair, most of our nations have fortunate natural endowments and geographical positions, but still face many challenges. May I mention, among others, the need to further diversify our economies and become more economically resilient and produce more goods and services with a higher percentage of local content. The need to increase our entry into the global value chains through modernized education and innovation to make sure that our own populations, especially young people, can have decent jobs and prosperous enterprises. The need to protect the environment and mitigate adverse results of climate change while still being able to create sustainable development based on our natural resources and with inclusions of the remote populations. The need to expand infrastructure, both hard and soft, and raise the connectivity between our regions. A recent UNCTAD report of 2018, the report on key statistics and trends in economic integration of the ACP region, states the following. Many member states are highly dependent on primary goods export and rely on few developed country markets for export revenues. But Intra-ACP trade, fortunately, has had a higher manufacturing and technology content and thus offers possibility to diversify export product baskets and increase the domestic content of the ACP countries in more sophisticated products. This means we are on the right track. However, there are still challenges. Like in maritime transport, which is the backbone of the world trade, in merchandise goods, this is not sufficiently efficient in many ACP countries to promote rapid trade growth and growth among the states. We are still low in e-commerce and our productivity gap is too big. It is for this reason that the Surinamese, that in Suriname, just recently we established a productivity center to tackle this last problem, the low productivity, and to improve labor productivity and efficiency. Chair and colleagues, I think we must work towards being more the designers of our own destination and be more in the driver's seat of issues of common interest. The ACP is an important stronghold to support each other, and the mission in Belgium on behalf of the government of Suriname is committed to stay actively engaged. Chair, Excellencies, Secretary General, colleagues, it is great to be here in the new environment of Brussels. I wish to meet new colleagues and friends, and I look forward to continuous cooperation. Thank you.